half a sheep covering.
The arts of the etheria.
The etheria.
On the boulevard, we have the Uniting Church of Australia, largely a Korean, the Korean community here use this church. One thing about it, well, I'll just point out a few things, but basically you have the triptych there, the sort of three doorways or windows. The thing about this church is that you have the arc, the archway going over that also. So you kind of have like a beehive, in a way, structure over that, with this emanation sort of further emanation from where the keystone is right there, from that archway, from that, what I would suggest is an etheric archway. An etheric archway. Interesting to have the sort of shapes there also at the sides, but nonetheless, we'll just have a look at further around here. You'll see the accentuation of the triptych going up the building. Real emphasis here. So again, the doorway here where the person would be, the mage, with the kind of auric shape around it. Further up the building here, on another level, potentially another further dimensional level, you have these three doors here. Now, within the church, you can see the three entities in those doorways. So, you can kind of see them here, but in this photo within the church, you have the three entities within the triptych there. And just as a bit of detail up here, you will see that the triptych is further sort of completed going up this building, and there's a real emphasis here on that. So going further around, this is the eastern part of the building, and again the similar configuration. This time you have the grapes going up through the middle, and there are three crowns within here, and notably one of the crowns is made of foliage, one of the crowns is made of thorns, and the other crown is the, you know, sort of regular king's or queen's crown, if you will. Now also here is the architectural formation yet again. So the 1 2 3 1 2 3. This time though you have the doorway, and then we have those, but really you could bring them down once again. Now in Liverpool I sort of showed that with that building with the, what I would suggest, the sort of auric curves, auric shapes if you will around. So here we have it here also, and then this detail going up here where once again the triptych is a major part of what's going on in this building. Now, you can see the spire with the foliage, the tree of life, the tree of the knowledge, of good and evil and everything up there also, sort of finishing off this this structure, if you will, this maybe this sort of architectural emanation from above in a way. So just pointing some things out here. Just back to these windows here, within the detail also you have what is a slight accentuation, I would suggest, of an emanation from the flowers when looking at the windows from the inside. So of course the crowns up there, the crown of thorns, the crown, the wreath of flowers would all relate to the crown chakra. And of course you can see the queen in Martin Place with the flowers around within that kind of auric dome right there. Looks like I'm getting a camera on me right now. That might be Google. Who is that? Yeah, Google Maps. Anyway, so just to show this configuration within the church here. Now within the Bible, within the church here, you can see the cross and the foliage and a pillar in an alchemical kind of a form. The Bible text in this case is written in Korean. I would suggest there are secrets hidden subtly within Strathfield's Trinity Uniting Church, formerly known as the Trinity Congregational Church. Now, congregational in itself is interesting because of the Trinity of the Three in within the magic ritual space, I would certainly suggest. But beyond that, and I know that's off the cards for most researchers out there, but so within that church, you have, for a start, you have, I am the vine, ye are the branches. And I would certainly suggest this refers to an aspect of the chakra system and the connectivity between entities. And indeed, where that window is, that would kind of run up the church and up the spire, the top spire of the church. And indeed, that foliage would be represented there also, kind of running right through this church in a symbolic way. And of course, that vine would run within you, as shown in the windows by the depiction of either the plant, the foliage within those windows, or the entities within those windows also. Note from the scripture there, ye are the branches. It is referring to you. It is about you. Now, within the chakra system, you would have the chakras and they would whirl. So in this depiction, you have what is perhaps the flower, the portal of the chakra system there. And as Ledbetter writes about, you have a force from the higher world rushing from that in masonry. And perhaps within the Bible also, they are both great architects. You would have this force rushing forth from these etheric chakra centers, flower-like centers. With the lilies in the window, you have an emanation, the carpal there, sort of emanating subtly from the lilies. You would also see that within Ledbetter's drawings. You would also, I would suggest, see that within Egypt also. So you can see that whirling there. We will now go back to the crown or the wreath of flowers. And within that, within the fine detail, you can see that swirling there also from the flower and that extra extension from the flower there at the crown chakra. Just as you can see, it may remind you of the Queen once again, or this depiction with Jesus. So they're very subtle about this, and really it's just for keen eyes to see. I am the vine, ye are the branches. The Trinity Uniting Church has a very prominent organ within the church. Now, the church was designed by architects George Sidney Jones and Harold Thompson in 1889. Architect George Sidney Jones was the grandson of retailer David Jones. In Australia to this day, we still have the David Jones department stores. Once upon a time, Freemasons could purchase a new apron from the David Jones regalia department on the first floor of the department store in Sydney. Priests could buy a new cassock also. Was George Sidney Jones a Freemason or a person within an occult order? I'm not sure, but nonetheless, I hope you enjoyed the video.